State Water Project is important to California because, if you can imagine, most of California's water supplies are stored as snow in the Sierra Nevada mountains. The function of the State Water Project is to move that water and distribute it all over California, from the Bay Area down to the border of Mexico, to get that water where it's needed. And that water actually supports 27 million Californians, millions of whom are from disadvantaged communities. It also supports 700,000 acres of agriculture. And all of these things taken together mean that the State Water Project supports the fifth largest economy in the world. The State Water Project consists of hundreds of miles of aqueducts and channels and 26 dams. And much of this infrastructure was constructed more than 50 years ago. It provides an enormous benefit beyond just clean water supplies. It generates power for Californians, it protects Californians from flood, and it also supplies critical water to environmental habitats. The Delta itself is a critical link in how the State Water Project moves water from the Sierra Nevada mountains, our reservoirs, and to all parts of California. And we do that in the Delta through levees that are in some places more than 100 years old. A major concern for the State Water Project's operational resilience is the effect of sea level rise and earthquake risk on these Delta levees, particularly because they are so old. The seismic risk in the Delta is significant. We're looking at about a 75% chance of an earthquake that's a magnitude of 6.5 or greater in the area at some point in the next 20 years. Whereas the major risk of a seismic event in the area would be an outage of the system, sea level rise proposes a really different challenge, and that is a slow-moving saltwater intrusion into the Delta that fouls the water supply at our current facilities. And in that case, that water would become too salty for the State Water Project to serve to California. On top of these risks that I mentioned, the Sierra snowpack itself is also at risk due to a warming climate. We know that that snowpack is going to diminish. And what will happen in its place is we will have more frequent, wetter storm events. And what we need to be positioned to do in California is move that water when it's available. Because moving that water and storing that water is going to help Californians weather longer and deeper droughts, which of course is the other side of the climate change hydrology. Given all of these challenges and the importance of the State Water Project to California, modernizing conveyance in the Delta is an essential response to a changing climate, including different points of diversion and upgrading the levee system to a tunnel system to transport that water will make the State Water Project itself more reliable in the face of a changing hydrology. People often ask, is this just the same water fix twin tunnel project? And in principle, yes. Yes, in that we are proposing new diversion points and a new modernized way to transport Delta water. What is different is the scaling down of the project. The 6,000 cubic feet per second proposed project is scaled to support, not replace, local investment in stormwater capture, water conservation, recycled water projects, and groundwater management. In fact, reliable water supplies from the Delta are critical to right-sizing recycled water projects and making sure that groundwater basins are clean and sustainable into the future.